developers, and in particular about the role of Qt, the development framework, that today is part of our Symbian product line as well as part of the MeeGo work that we're doing. This was a lot of questions about what happens with Qt. You see it as important. What is the developer opportunity and what happens? So the way I would characterize this is, first of all, as Joe just supported, demand for Symbian is still ahead. There are easily a quarter of a billion Symbian devices either existing or in the future that will have the Qt framework as part of what we're shipping. That is a huge opportunity for developers, and one that will be continuing to encourage for many months, quarters, and years ahead. So that is a big opportunity. It is also the case that the MeeGo device, the first MeeGo device that will ship this year, will also take advantage of the Qt framework, which is an opportunity to work with it there as well. The question, of course, is what about Qt on Windows Phone? Will Nokia put Qt on Windows Phone? And our initial response to that is that, no, that's not the plan. And here is the reason behind that. If we, on the Windows Phone platform, encourage essentially a forking, a divergence of development platforms between what natively is provided on the Windows Phone platform and Qt, then we create the environment where potentially we could confuse the developers, confuse the consumers, of course, very challenging, and even create an environment where Windows Phone can advance slower than the competition because we're carrying two principal development platforms instead of one. So we wanted to put that question to rest. Now at the same time, there has been a lot of speculation in the blogosphere about whether Qt is part of our next billion strategy. Will Qt go down to that next level? And we want to be very clear that we have not made any decisions about Qt for the next billion and that strategy. So this is an area to consider going forward. So there's some comments on developers.
Give it to the community.
On the fourth question that we'd like to spend a moment on, and that is the future of MeeGo, the relationship with Intel, and the MeeGo.com open source initiative. It is the case, as we said, that we would ship our first MeeGo device this year, and then transition that effort into an exploration of the next generation of disruption, the next generation of platforms, of devices, and of user experiences. That is what we'll be focusing on as it relates to this area. Now, MeeGo will be part of the consideration and part of the exploration that we pursue going forward. Now, we still have some work to do to define next steps in this area. Absolutely the case that there's some work ahead. But we have been in consultation with Intel, including myself talking to Mr. O'Leary on multiple occasions through our decision-making process, including immediately after we made our final decision to go Windows Phone, as that took place just Thursday night of last week. So we made sure that Intel was aware of our decision-making process. We've been in consultation with them, and they were certainly aware of our decision before any of you were aware of that. Now it is the case, I think on Tuesday, myself and Mr. O'Leary and other representatives from Intel and Nokia will work together to begin to chart the future course in this area. So we have more work to do. We wanted to clarify some of what had been said in that area. Number five.
Hi, Stephen. This is Paul Mooney of Intune Network. The MeeGo developer community would like to know about your commitment to MeeGo, the MeeGo platform. Can you give me an idea in euros of how much development you're going to put behind them in the next year?
Yeah, we don't share specific euro value or dollar values of investments in specific projects or activities, so I won't share the particular amount. But it's absolutely the case, if you think about it strategically around Nokia, smartphones, the next billion, and the future disruptions, we have to place a significant investment against that next disruption. That's our future. We have to make sure that we are investing appropriately against that. Now, the precise amounts we're not going to say, and we still have work to do with Intel to say, what does this mean in the context of the changes and so forth? We have a lot of still decisions and things to make. But nonetheless, there will be real investment against this next future disruption, of which MeeGo is likely a part of. At the same time, we can decide that other possibilities exist. I want to be clear about that. Future disruptions, there's a lot of other things, even on top of or related to MeeGo, that could be relevant. HTML5 comes to mind, which is a component of it, could be related to MeeGo. So just something I want to